All right, hello everybody. Welcome back to some more Stormworks Build and Rescue. Let's see. In the last video, I said we were ready to depart, and we departed. And I realized that we were not actually ready to leave yet, sadly. Sadly, there is still some more work that needs to be done to the ship before we can be ready to go. So that's what we're working on right now. See if we can... So what I forgot was this, obviously, was to hook up the hopper. And what was the other one here? Yeah, I wanted to put in a monitor here because I have right now I have no way of telling how full this is, how much uranium is in here, right? I have no idea. So, let's see, we need engine stats. I have no way of telling and it would be nice to do that to be able to see if it's how full it is. Right. Alrighty. So, as far as I understand, these are all connected. This becomes one giant hopper. So I don't need to connect each individual one. But what I should do is, let's see here. I should have a, I should probably have one for there too. And then that way I can just discover the whole process, right, as it's working. Get rid of this. I don't need to change this from temp. It can stay as temp. I'm just rewriting it to uranium, but I don't have to just because it's here as temp, right? That's just that's the name of the variable. I could name it, you could name it whatever. The variable, you just have to make sure that these are the same so it knows which input to grab. All right, so we'll do that. We'll update that one. And then get another monitor. I'm sure there's something else I'll have forgotten. I'm sure of it. I'm sure there'll be something else I'll have forgotten. All right. Let's see. What's this? Not just a backlight. I'm not going to be too concerned about that right now. Okay. I think that's it. I'm not going to worry about connecting that either. I think that's it. All right. I think I can say with confidence we're ready. Ready to do it. My hope is, unlike plan A, plan B, where I can successfully get the uranium back to the ship. Now, it would have worked in plan A. I don't know. They say that it's impossible to tell. You know, once two logic nodes get close together, they do strange things. So maybe, you know, whatever was happening is whatever was happening. I don't know what happened. All I know is we went to space. And we didn't need a rocket to do it. That's all I know. So my hope is that we're not going to go to space this time. Right? We're going to be successful. And we're going to get this uranium. This is like 85 or something. Oh my goodness. Why am I, man? So the engines, they'll have a certain throttle setting, which is their like peak, whatever. And then you can throttle to 100%, but then you saw there, the RPS was bouncing back and forth, right? So we don't want to do that. We want the engines to be, they're not going to overheat or anything, but it just, yeah. So what we're going to do is we're going to replace this with a keypad, which is what I should have done, but we're doing it right now. And so I just find that the throttle is a little bit too sensitive. Like, it's really hard to dial it in, right? So at least this way with the keypad, you can put it in an exact number, and it'll stop at that exact number. Whereas with the throttle, you have to go up and down, 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 and it can be really hard to dial it in, right? So, all right, please. Let's just get out of here. I think I'm on the moon. How high I'm jumping. Yeah, clutch doesn't matter. That's going to be at 100%. But this here, we want it to be at like, we'll try 72, right? And then this way we can get, I can get an exact reading on it. And then I don't have to sit there and fumble and fumble and fumble and fumble. Usually what I do is I'll fumble with it for a little while. And then once I find the number, I'll just put a constant number on it. And then that way it just, that's where it'll run. But I guess in this case with the big ship, it is nice to kind of be able to throttle down. And that is the nice thing about the throttle, is it's nice to be able to throttle down, but it just doesn't seem to be working. Does turn nice. For a big ship, this thing does turn nice. All right, so 72, let's see, can we go to 73? Yeah, 73 seems all right. And of course, what I'm thinking is, yeah, this is our subcarrier. Eventually, I'm gonna make another ship this big. As much as I regret it, I'm going to. Oh yes. And we will. Well, we're gonna change it. We're gonna make the front look like a real ship. And all that stuff. All right, so that works. 73. Can we go to 74? Or is that too much? Might be too much. Right, if the RPS goes up too fast, it'll peak, and then we'll have that bouncing, right? And that's what we're trying to avoid. We don't want the RPS to be bouncing up and down. That ships, it might not matter too much, but let's say this was an airplane or something like that, a helicopter. That's when it really does matter, because you'll start to get, the plane will wobble, and you'll have all these, well, that's actually pretty good. 74 seems, 74 is going to work. What are we at, 9? Yeah, nice. All right. So with the helicopter on there and the cranes, I don't think we'll be able to fit under the, we won't be able to take the river. So we'll have to sail around the continent here. So it's a good thing we have lots of fuel, maybe. Hopefully. Oh my. Well, let's see, 50% would be 60,000. So, and then worst case scenario, instead of being able to come all the way back here to Holt Town, I'll have to come back, I'll have to dock at another port, which is fine. Disconnect that. Oh boy. The foghorn doesn't work. Ah! Man! Oh well, we're going for it. We're going for it this time. Holy, look at these waves. We're going for it this time. Should hopefully be enough light. I don't know about inside. I think I'll put a couple of lights. Yeah, a couple of lights inside. You know, it's nighttime, right? Doesn't need to be super duper bright. That's pretty cool down there. And the helicopter might not even work. I don't even know if there's any jet fuel for it. So that was something I forgot to check as well. But that's all right. I wonder what else isn't working. I am a little concerned. Seems like, ooh, I just need to verify that the power grid here is all right. Seems to be consistent all the way through. We aren't gaining or losing electricity. So I don't know if I should be concerned by that or not. I am not sure if that should concern me. All right, well, we'll roll with it. We'll roll with it. I mean, it could be enough power grid here to keep things stable. Like, there really isn't that much on the vessel anymore. That's just a few lights, and I mean, we have all this huge power grid capacity, so. How are we doing for fuel? Bad. So we'll have to, we're coming around this way. I mean, I really hope we have the fuel. I really hope we have the fuel to get there. Like, yeah. We should, because I made it there in the, with the other ship. Same engines, all that stuff, so. All right. Right, and these waves are pretty small. I know once we try and sail through the Arctic, the waves get huge. Once you get north off the continental shelf, the waves get pretty big. So, all the equipment is in the back of the ship. Let's see what we got. Binoculars. Just night vision binoculars. All right. Whoa. These things work really well. I like that. They changed how these things work. Doing for fuel. What's that over there? Oh, there's the town way over there. That's right. All right, well, I should check on these monitors too, huh? Perfect. close my door. Close that door down there. Yeah. Everything is sealed. I don't have a life support system on this ship yet. And that'll be something else I'll have to add later on. I wonder where it's going to come from. And then we have to figure out where we can cross. Right there. Yeah, I'll have to cross through there. So I'll have to stay away from the shoreline. Yeah, so $600,000 in fuel is what this thing cost, plus the ship, $400,000, something like that. It's getting to be too much. So if it works, I'll have to attempt to fill this thing up with uranium. It's the only way to make this thing work. Otherwise, it's just too expensive. But yeah. It's too expensive. I don't know how I'd recoup that cost. $600,000 in fuel. Can't do it running missions. The only way to recoup that cost is by trading fuel. It'd probably take, I can't even estimate that. Several hours, anyhow. Probably 10 hours of just trading fuel. Maybe more to try and recoup that cost. Should be able to make it though. It's 25,000. Yeah, I should be almost about 50%. That's crazy. All right, we gotta get all the way down to here. This is the entrance here. So we gotta get all the way down to there. We'll see how she goes. No, I mean, I could always slow down the engines, so we just crawl. Oh, I'm getting water in there. Sucking in water on the one side. Oh boy. Well, that should help a little bit with the fuel economy anyhow. Always something, right? Always something. Let's see how long, what we're looking at here. Minor waves. Oh, you know what else? I forgot a lot of things. My goodness, we are not ready yet to. Oh man. I didn't put a cable connection on the sub, so there's no way for me to recharge it. And I didn't put a hose connection on the sub, so there's no way for me to refuel the sub. It's too much to think about. My goodness. Well, we'll get there this time. We'll see if we can do one successful load. And if we can, then, like I say, I've always got the autosave. I'll just load the autosave. Put those few things on it, and then we can try again. It's just refueling would be important. It doesn't take much, and I know it only sips fuel when it's going, but it would be nice to be able to refuel it just so we can, if this is successful, we'll do those tweaks. I might do another fuel run in the truck just so that way I got enough fuel to come back here if this is successful. If it's not successful, then we're going to be turning this submarine into a helicopter. And we'll be flying over here. Right, so that's one of the things about the diesel engines is you have to, you don't have to, but it's good to dial them in so you're not over throttling the RPS and the engine is going up and down like that. It's good to just dial it in. Otherwise, yeah, if you were in a helicopter, I'm just going to check this helicopter here and see if there's any fuel in it. Oh yeah, we got a little bit of fuel in here. We could go for a little spin in the helicopter. That'd be cool. I think we're actually going to be on the inside of that airport. Oh, there'll be some more waves coming. We want to be just slightly this way. Well, we're getting there eventually. Yeah, not bad. We'll have just over half a tank. Wow. So 300,000 in fuel just to get out here. I don't know. It's just one of those games, right? Takes time. You can't rush it. You just have to spend the time. All right, what's going on here? Yeah, you just have to spend the time and do the trading. I am curious though if you get more than one oil platform in the industrial frontier there, the expansion. Or if you only get one on the land. Let's see what Google says. Three land-based sites. Yeah. So that's what you get when you pay. That's what we'll have to do. That's not much. It's like $6. It was on for $6 on Steam. What is it? It's like $12 or something for the expansion. So, but that is what I'll end up having to do here. Probably is get the industrial expansion so I can get more fuel so we can make this work. So you'll get four. You get the three on the industrial frontier. That's what Google says. I can't personally confirm that until I get the DLC, obviously. And then you get the one offshore here, which is actually that's decent. You know, if they're all comparable for fuel in that, I mean, that's almost 4 million. All if you were to sell it all, that's a decent amount. So. That's probably what we're going to have to do in order to make this work. We're going to have to figure something like that out. Oh, we're going to. Nice, getting there. See, we got now I tried to get into the tower and I couldn't, the door wouldn't open. The elevator would go up to the tower, but it wouldn't open up so I could explore the tower. I don't know if you ever could explore the tower, but I did try over here. And I couldn't get into the tower. I'll have to try again. then probably what we'll do is we'll wait for a calm day, and then we'll launch, and that way this ship hopefully won't drift too far away from where we launch, and it'll just make the whole operation go a lot smoother. Now, if I'm not attached to this ship, I'm hoping we don't go to space. One, and two, I'm also hoping there's keep active blocks on this vessel. So my hope is it doesn't despawn or disappear. I mean, the ship didn't the last time, so yeah, I'm just hoping it doesn't disappear. We'll see what happens. Now, kind of have to be careful because there's a bit of a shelf here. So we don't want to... Yeah, I think we'll actually be all right if we head straight in there. All right, finally, we have arrived. sure we're in the right location. I think we are. I think this is the right spot here. Yeah, there. I can see the cliff right there. Perfect. All right. All righty, we'll save it here. Let's see, uranium test. We'll do that. Yeah, all right. Well, I think we're going to end this one here. Thanks for riding along. It was quite the journey. We've made it. And the next step will be to launch down into the cave there and see if we can gather some uranium. So thanks for watching. Thanks for liking. Thanks for subscribing. You guys rock, and we will see you in the next one.